And do you think now that social media is such a big thing, do you think that social media has a lot to do with political elections and mm-hmm. stuff like that?
Oh, no question. No question. I mean, we see it at every level of government. We saw it at the national level. And people get stoked up and they get in their echo chambers. And, you know, I think, you know, people need to listen to other people more, you know, and listen with compassion and kindness and not with, you know, vitriol or let me tell you how it is. You know, listen to what they're saying and where they're coming from and take a little deeper look than just locking horns. So, but yes, there's no question that social media has changed our world, and in some cases not for the better, in some cases for the better. I mean, I've made a lot of connections I wouldn't have made. But right now, 2021, I'd say it's spun out of control. I mean, look what's happening. They've banned the ex-president from Twitter.
Yeah.
I mean, you almost don't even notice that, right? Mm-hmm. But you stop and think about it. They banned the ex-president from tweeting. I mean, that means something. I'm not quite sure yet, but yeah. So yes, it's definitely had a huge impact. And people, I think, are in the midst of trying to figure it out the same way we're trying to figure out COVID. And we will.
Do you think that Twitter's decision to block Trump was a good idea? No matter what political side you're on, do you think that it's okay for a certain social media company to restrict access to someone who's putting out certain ideas that could be intending certain ideas if they go against social, I mean, civil?
Yeah, stuff? No, I hear what you're saying. And what's happened with social media is you have icons at the top of their industry making decisions like this. They're ultimately censoring it. If it was run by the federal government, would they censor someone like that? You know, some people would say he's screaming fire in a movie theater. Mm-hmm. You know, and other people think he's speaking the truth. And you're silencing the truth. So it's my problem with it right now. I forgot who the CEO of Twitter is, but he's ultimately the one making the decision. It's Mark Zuckerberg at Facebook that's making the decision. It's Jeff Bezos at Amazon that's making the decision. And so that's where I think some things have to be reassessed. And I don't know how, because things have spun out of control a little bit. But is it right to have banned Trump? If he's inciting riots, which a lot of people think he was, then yeah, sure. It's like screaming fire in a movie theater. Talk to other people and they think, you know, you've silenced the truth. So it's a tough one.
Yeah, that with social media and somewhat censorship, it's hard to see, or it's hard to pick one side, because there's good things about it, there's bad things about it, and
it is a form of censorship. There's no question about it, except that, you know, when people start in, you know, if you believe that somebody incited a riot and five people died, okay, you're not going to use my tool to do that anymore.
Yeah,
and I could easily see a CEO saying, okay, he's out, and I mean, people died, and there was a riot, and they tried to overthrow the Democratic government. So.
Yeah.
I totally get that more than the other side, but again, it's about listening to the other side, and you know, you have to balance it. But yeah, in general, probably if I was a CEO of Twitter, I would have banned him too after five people died, and he stood out there and said, you know, you're not going to win with weakness. And I don't think there's any question that he had sided that crowd.